Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to take a list of names in numbers and sort them using last name first. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So back at the beginning of this year, I showed you how to take a list of names like this and then convert them to last name, first name, like this, using some complex formulas and lots of extra columns. The technique I used involved first figuring out how many spaces were in the name, which turns out to be very difficult. You have to count how many characters with spaces and subtract how many characters without spaces to get that number. Then you had to substitute a special character, like a semicolon, for the last space in the name. So first name and middle name remain together and last name is separate. Then you find the location of that space. And from there, you could use left and then right to get the first name and the last name separately. And then you could put those two together. Now that's pretty complex, but fortunately, since I made that video, Apple introduced some new functions that make this a lot easier. Now the basic idea remains the same. We need to figure out where that last space is. So we find the space between George and Washington, but we also find the space between Quincy and Adams in John Quincy Adams. Fortunately, there's a new function that will take care of this for us. It's called count matches. So we'll use count matches. And if we look it up here, we can see it takes the source string and the search string. So the source string is the name here, and the search string is simply a space. So a space between two quotes. And we can see we get one here. If I copy and paste that throughout, you can see I get ones mostly, but I'll get a two where there's a middle name or a first name and an initial. Now to grab the actual last name, all we need to do is grab everything after the last space. So there's another new function called text after. And if we look that up, we could see that it takes sort string, search string, and occurrence. So occurrence is where that number comes in handy. If there's just one space, we need to look for what's after the first space. If there are two spaces because of a middle name, we need to look for what's after the second space. So we could simply do text after, and then this is the source. What we're looking for is a space. So again, quote, space, quote. But then we leave the count matches there. So it's going to look for the first occurrence if there's one space, second occurrence if there are two spaces. And now this will return for us the last name. So we can see it works for that. And if I paste it throughout, you can see it even works for cases where there is a middle name. Now getting everything before this is essentially the same thing, except instead of text after, we use text before. So I'm going to copy this entire thing and I'm going to paste it before it with a ampersand and then quote, comma, space, quote, ampersand. So it's basically going to put a comma and a space between the first and last name. So it's going to find the last name and then a comma and a space. And then instead of text after, let's use the new text before, which is the same as text after, except it's going to return the opposite part of the string, everything before that space. So text after will give us the last name. Then we have a comma and a space. And then text before will give us everything before the last name, including a first name and middle name. So now we can see here we get Washington, George. If I copy and paste that throughout, you can see it works for John Quincy Adams. It works for William Henry Harrison. So now we have one function. It's not short, but it's much easier to understand. Things like text after, count matches, text before are pretty straightforward. And now we can call this column last first. And if we want to sort alphabetically, we can sort using this column and get last name, first name sorting rather than first name, last name. You can even see here it works for George H.W. Bush because Bush is after the last space and everything before the last space is put after the comma. What about Martin Van Buren? How did it work for Martin Van Buren? Shouldn't it be Buren, Martin Van? Well, Van Buren is a last name despite the fact it has a space in it. In a special case like this, you need to indicate that the space isn't a word separating space by going in and instead of having a regular space, like I'll type a space here, and now you can see it actually does do Buren, comma, Martin Van. But if instead of that, I hold the Option key down and then hit space, it puts a non-breaking space, a different character. than a regular space between Van and Buren. So now Van and Buren are kept together because that's not a real space between those two words. It's an option space or non-breaking space. So you just have to be aware in special situations like this to use that special character in order to get last and first working correctly. Now since I'm showing you the new functions text before and text after, I did want to take time to show you another one called text between. So text between works by taking the source string and then a first character to look for and a second character to look for. And you can also do a first occurrence and second occurrence. So for instance, if we wanted to use George Washington as an example here, I can look for everything between the first O and the first I, and it will give me the text between the O and the I. And you can see it works like that. But I could also include occurrences. So I could look for spaces, look for the first occurrence, and then I can look for the first occurrence after that. So you would think you would put a 2 here to find the middle name. In fact, you put 1 to be the next occurrence after that. And this will give me the middle name. Of course, George Washington doesn't have one. But if I copy and paste, you can see I can indeed get Quincy and Henry here. George H.W. Bush doesn't capture both the H and the W because it's looking for the space after George and then the next space. But if we use the same technique before and do count matches in this text and the number of spaces there, then we subtract 1 because we're not counting that first space here, then we actually do get everything between the first space and the last space. We can make this a little nicer by using if error and then just having a blank. So instead of an error, we'll get blank there. And if there is no error, we'll get the actual value. So I copy and paste this throughout. And now you can see I get just the middle names when a middle name is available. Now it turns out there's also another way using another new function to be able to do this. It's using regular expressions. Now regular expressions are a lot more complex. So for most people, it's going to be easiest to understand text after, text before, and count matches than a regular expression. But if you like regular expressions, you basically use the substitute function to substitute one thing for another inside of text. The thing we're going to look at is the name. Then we're going to use regex inside a substitute, which will allow us to do a really complex search inside the original text. It's basically going to look for two things with a space in between them. And the dot and asterisk stand for basically any number of any character. So it's going to look for any number of any character, then a space, and any number of any character after that. The way regex works, the space is the last space it finds. So in other words, everything before the last space and everything after the last space. And then it's going to substitute the reverse of this. So it's going to take the second object, this thing, which should be the last name, then a comma and a space, and then the first thing it finds, everything before the last space, should be the first and middle names or initials. And we see this rather short formula does exactly the same as this much longer one. It's just a little harder to understand. And if I copy and paste that throughout, you can see it works pretty well, including recognizing our special non-breaking space, including recognizing middle names, and even including recognizing multiple middle names or initials. So that's how you can use new functions like text before, text after, text between, count matches, substitute, and regex to make it a lot easier to create simple functions that convert a regular name to last name, comma, first name, so you can sort them in numbers. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.